الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. معالي حميد القطامي مدير عام هيئة الصحة بدبي رؤساء جمعية طب الطوارئ، أعضاء مجلس إدارة جمعية الإمامات الطبية، الزملاء الأفاضل وضيوفنا الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إنه لمن دواعي فخرنا بأن يعقد المؤتمر الخامس لشعبة الإمامات لطب الطوارئ تحت الرعاية الكريمة لسمو الشيخ حمدان بن راشد آل مكتوم نائب حاكم إمامة دبي، وزير المالية والصناعة، ورئيس هيئة الصحة بدبي حفظه الله ورعاه، الذي يؤكد بدعمه الدائم واللامحدود لمثل هذه الأنشطة العلمية بأن دولتنا الحبيبة ستبقى محل أنظار العالم. لذا لا يسعني وباسمكم جميعا إلا أن أتوجه بالشكر والتقدير لرعايته هذا الحدث العلمي.
In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful, His Excellency Hamid Al-Qattami, Director General of the Dubai Health Authority, Emergency Medicine Association's Presidents, Emirates Medical Association's Board Members, Distinguished Delegates. It is my greatest pleasure to welcome you all to the fifth edition of Emirates Society of Emergency Medicine Conference 2018. We are privileged by the patronage of His Highness Sheikh Hamdan bin Rashid Al Maktoum, Deputy Ruler of Dubai, UAE Minister of Finance and Industry, President of the Dubai Health Authority, whose relentless support towards the scientific and medical events helped mark Dubai and the UAE as destinations for international scientific and medical conferences. Therefore, on behalf of the ESEM's organizing committee and faculty, we extend our gratitude to His Highness for his support, which promoted advancements in the healthcare standards of the UAE.
فلنبدأ حفلنا الآن مع ما تيسر من الذكر الحكيم.
And now for a recitation of the verses from the Holy Quran.
حضورنا الكريم، لقد حقق المؤتمر هذا العام نجاحاً كبيراً باستقطابه هذه النخبة الكريمة من الخبراء العالميين في مجال طب الطوارئ، وبالدعم الذي لاقاه من هيئة الصحة بدبي. وإنه لمن دواعي سرورنا أن ندعو ممثل وعي الحفل معالي حميد القطامي مدير عام هيئة الصحة بدبي ليلقي كلمته مشكوراً.
Distinguished guests, with each passing conference, we continue to make strides towards new milestones by attracting more than 1,000 delegates from over 30 countries, all from different backgrounds and varying walks of life, which makes it the largest medical conference in the region. A special thank you to the Dubai Health Authority for their advocation from the very beginning. And now, I would like to call upon His Excellency Hamid Al-Qattami, Director General of the Dubai Health Authority, to address the conference.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السيدات والسادة، الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يطيب لنا بداية أن نتقدم بكل الشكر والامتنان إلى سمو الشيخ حمدان بن راشد آل مكتوم نائب حاكم دبي، وزير المالية، رئيس هيئة الصحة بدبي، لرعاية سموه الكريمة لأعمال المؤتمر الخامس لشعبة الإمارات لطب الطوارئ. كما يسرنا ونحن نرحب بكم أيها الحضور الكريم في هذا الحدث السنوي المهم أن نعرف عن اعتزازنا بفوز مدينة دبي باستضافة المؤتمر العالمي لطب الطوارئ في دورته 2021، وأن نعرب كذلك عن تقديرنا البالغ لفرق العمل التي أنجزت ملف الاستضافة الذي كان محل منافسة بين ملفات أخرى تقدمت بها كل من واشنطن وملبورن الأسترالية للفوز بتنظيم هذه التظاهرة العلمية الأكبر من نوعها وتخصصها دوليا. السيدات والسادة، لقد شهد العالم خلال العقدين الماضيين على وجه التحديد الكثير من القضايا والإشكاليات الصحية، من انتشار الأوبئة وارتفاع معدلات الإصابة والحوادث واعتلال الأمراض المزمنة، الأمر الذي شكل مجموعة من التحديات أمام طب الطوارئ بوجه عام، كما منح هذا التخصص الحيوي مساحات إضافية لدوره الوقائي والعلاجي، وأوجد ضرورة حتمية لمواصلة تحديد أقسام الطوارئ والعمل الدائم على تطويرها وتزويدها بأحدث التجهيزات والتقنيات وتمكين القائمين عليها من أداء مسؤولياتهم على الوجه المرجو. وهذا بالتحديد ما تقوم به هيئة الصحة بدبي وتعمل عليه إيمانا منها بأن نجاح أي منشأة صحية يظل مرهونا بقدرة وكفاءة أقسام الطوارئ ومستوى استجابتها للحالات العاجلة والظروف الاستثنائية والطارئة. ولعلنا نفخر جميعا بأقسام الطوارئ لدينا، كما نفخر أيضا بالكوادر الطبية والطبية المساندة والفنية القائمة عليها، مما نقدر دورها وجهودها المبذولة من أجل خدمة المجتمع والحفاظ على صحة وحياة أفراده. وإننا في هيئة الصحة بدبي ندرك مكانة مدينتنا وموقعها وما تمثله من نقطة جذب عالمية للمؤتمرات والمنتديات والقمم وغير ذلك من الأحداث التي تتطلب دائما أن نكون في أتم الاستعداد لمواجهة أي ظروف طبية محتملة. ونحن إذ نعول كثيرا على أقسام الطوارئ لمواجهة أي تحديات أو إشكاليات طارئة، فإننا نؤكد أن الهيئة لا تدخر وسعا في تطوير أقسام الطوارئ ورفع مستوى الأداء فيها، لتظل هي الأفضل عالميا وتظل أيضا في المقدمة الرئيسية والمدخل الأساسي لرعاية الصحية العاجلة. لا أود الإطالة، ولا يسعني في ختام هذه الكلمة إلا أن أجدد شكري لكم أيها الحضور الكريم، وأخص بالذكر ضيوف دولتنا الكرام، كما أشكر جمعية الإمارات الطبية شعبة الإمارات لطب الطوارئ لتنظيمها هذا المؤتمر السنوي الناجح، والشكر موصول للجمعيات المتخصصة والمؤسسات الداعمة ورعاة المؤتمر وكل من أسهم في إخراج هذه الصورة المشرفة لمؤتمرنا. وفقكم الله لما في خير الناس وسعادتهم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
نشكر معاليه على كلمته الطيبة. أعزائنا الكرام، لا يسعنا هنا إلا أن نفخر بهذا الحدث المتميز بالوفرة العلمية والثراء الفكري، والذي يضم نخبة من خيرة الأطباء والعلماء. وهذا الإنجاز هو حصيلة جهود أعضاء شعبة الإمارات لطب الطوارئ. فليتفضل الدكتور صالح فارس رئيس الشعبة والمؤتمر لإلقاء كلمته مشكورة.
Thank you, Your Excellency, for your precious words. This conference is the fruit of diligent teamwork from the Emirates Society of Emergency Medicine members. Please welcome with me Dr. Saleh Faris, President of the Emirates Society of Emergency Medicine and Chairman of the conference.
As السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أرحب بكم جميعا. معاليك سعادة معالي حميد القطامي المدير العام لهيئة دبي الصحية. تسمح لي أرقي كلمتي باللغة الإنجليزية. Your Excellency حميد القطامي, Director General of Dubai Health Authority. Dr. Melanie Sanders, Vice President of the International Federation for Emergency Medicine. Dear Presidents, Representatives of International Societies, Ladies and Gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And on behalf of the Emergency Medicine Society, it is a great pleasure to welcome you all to the fifth edition of the Emergency of the ESEM conference here in Dubai under the patronage of His Highness Sheikh Hamdan bin Rashid Al Maktoum, Deputy Ruler of Dubai, UAE Minister of Finance, President of Dubai Health Authority. As an emergency provider, we're all proud today that our specialty is moving strongly forward. We managed to change the concept of an emergency department being the back door of hospitals a few years ago, where unfortunately the low performers used to be sent to emergency department. Now we became the front door to the hospital, where more than 30% of admissions are taken through the emergency department. That's a huge breakthrough that we're so proud of you as emergency providers to change this concept. Our indicators here in the UAE are not different from the international standards, and we're very proud of the level that the emergency care have reached so far. We at ESEM will dedicate all the efforts, knowledge, expertise toward the success and the development of emergency care in the country, and especially as we are approaching Expo 2020 here in Dubai in a few years. Moving forward, and hopefully to encourage the emergency medicine research and the development of education here in the country, ESEM will be announcing two new awards in 2019. The first would be ESEM Best Researcher Award and ESEM Best Educator Award. We want to really recognize and encourage research and also appreciate and acknowledge all the dedicated educators in the country and especially in the residency programs. We will be announcing the criteria, and we would love to see as many applications as possible. Furthermore, and as of next year, ESEM will have a humble offer for all emergency medicine residents that they will be able to register free of charge as of next year. And I would like to offer also other non-emergency medicine residents to reconsider their specialty if they want to join us. Most importantly, and a lot of people know how dear is this topic to my heart, as an update to the Good Samaritan law, an hour ago, I've been informed by the Ministry of Health that the final step within the Ministry of Health, it's called the Executive Council within the Ministry of Health, has approved the Good Samaritan law, and the next step will be the Cabinet of the UAE for a few last steps to be approving, as I mentioned, the first Good Samaritan law in an Arabic country. So keep praying, we're getting there. And alhamdulillah, it's a very positive momentum, and we're all happy to have this moving forward. I really want to thank all the committees, members. People ask me all the time, when do you start? How long do you prepare for this conference? Thinking back, we never stopped. We meet at the last day of this conference, and we program the next one. So literally, we don't stop, so we continue. So I want to thank my family. I want to thank my friends. The committee's really dedicated team. I'm very blessed with all the volunteers surrounding us. It's not a one-man show. It's a strong team who've been with us from the start and really dedicate hours, day, night, just to make this a huge success. I want to also thank people, the supporters, companies who've been with us throughout the years. There are special sponsors who always been with us in good and their good days and bad days, just to sponsor and support emergency medicine in the country, and especially such an important education activity. A very side discussion we had, you know, when we approach potential sponsors, one of them asked me, you know, sorry, but we don't have a good return of investment, you know, from previous conference. And I was, so I sent a message back saying, the only return of investment I can promise you is saving lives, because this is the best we could do. We cannot. So for those who believe in the importance of emergency care, please be with us. Otherwise, if you expect a bottom figure in your dollars money, we're not the big specialty. We don't sell stents for $150,000 or something. We have, you know, the most expensive equipment we have, I think, is what, an ultrasound and a ventilator. So, which we have one in each department in some places. So thank you all for supporting us, and you will see, we will try to demonstrate to you what we mean by saving lives. It's a beautiful joy. It's a strong feeling that you will see and feel, hopefully, in a few minutes with us. This is exactly what we feel as emergency providers when we finish our shifts and go home. You will feel, I hope we will try to make you feel some of what we feel. Finally, I want to encourage the junior colleagues here in the conference to network. We have the leaders of emergency medicine in one room, so make sure you network. There are so many projects came out of such meetings, textbooks, papers, electives, residencies, fellowships. So please tap into all the leaders here across the room. Make a plan to your future. If you need any help, ask them. If you need our help, please approach us at any time. This is your opportunity to build a strong future for yourself and for the country. To the whole ESEM team, I'm honored and thankful for all your hard work. Really, this success wouldn't be possible without your hard work and dedication. You always make us proud as an ESEM team for excellent commitment and integrity. You really make us proud of being here and networking with all of you. So thank you so much for making this a success. Thank you all. Please have a pleasant stay at the conference. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish you a very pleasant stay here in Dubai, our beautiful city, and please make the most out of this conference. And again, welcome to Dubai.
Good morning, everyone. I am the one that you talk about him now, and you saw about the screen. Alhamdulillah, before everything, thanks God. My name is Nasir Muhammad Kamel, I'm from Egypt. I am 55 years old. I have been working in emergency room in one of the hospitals in Abu Dhabi for about 9 years. My job is to translate between doctor, nurses, and the patient, and vice versa, in Arabic and English. Through these years, I saw many cases, some minor and the other are very critical. I also was a witness of many cardiac arrest cases. Some of them survived, but many, unfortunately, didn't. But never ever think that I will be one of those people I saw in trauma room, lying in the bed, and they are working like bees around me, trying to help and to make me survive. I was so lucky to collapse in the hospital, not in my car or at home or at the gym, that I was there a couple of minutes before. I was really blessed to have those kinds of angels, not doctors. They are working, dedicating people, working very hard, not with me, maybe a little bit more with me as a friend or colleague, but I was a witness for the trauma room, and they are doing there with all patients. They were really warriors in a very severe battle. Of course, I didn't see anything, but I have been told from the colleague, from my friends, from the physicians themselves. As a witness of many cases, usually after 10, 15, maximum 25 minutes, they announce death of the body because there is no way to get him back. But with me, with more than 25 shocks, for more than 55 minutes in this room, trying to help, trying to make me back. Some of them told me before, after I wake up and came back, there were a battle between nurses, physicians, therapists, and the death. This took me some time. They got me back. This is the conflict in this room. This is what they saw, because many times my heart stops and back to normal. Today I'm standing here among a good and a very big group of experts from all over the world. I have a lot of things to say, but the time is very short. But here I am to inspire you. You don't need my inspiration, but you really feel it when you find somebody like me standing here. I myself, I cannot believe that I come back. But after God's will and the good work they did, I'm here telling you my story. Today I'm standing among a group of expert emergency physicians from all over the world. You probably see many cases similar to mine, but you might not have the chance to see a survivor after a very critical case. I also want to thank Dr. Rasha Mohamed, the one who invited me here. She is really one of the best. I have a lot of best doctors there, many doctors there, but she was one of the best of them. She really a good physician. I also have a doctor called Ahmed Ali. He's sitting with us today. He got another talent next to medicine. He is a good writer. He writes many short stories. And he summarized my story in a very short story. It is available outside. I will be there next to the desk to show you. It is in Arabic. If you like to take a look on it, please go ahead and take a copy and to see the complicated cases I have passed through. Finally, I want to say something about the job of medicine or physician. I don't consider it as a job. It is a mission. You are not here as like any employee come to the work and go back to home. No, you are in a mission. We see the people or the doctor are in a shift for 8 hours. They stay for 10, 11 hours until they finish the cases they have. Finally, I want to quote something from Hippocrates. He said, "As a caregiver, you see selfless acts every day. Wherever the art of medicine is loved, there is also a love of humanity." Thank you all. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Nosheh, for sharing such a significant time of your life. Thank you for your generosity.
الزملاء الأفاضل، إن البصمة العالمية لهذا المحفل العلمي هي أساس استقطاب حضورنا الكريم ووجود هذه النخبة المتميزة من المتحدثين على المستوى الإقليمي والعالمي. قد أثرت مؤتمرنا فيما يختص بطب الطوارئ. فرحبوا معي بالدكتور نديم قرشي، رئيس اللجنة العلمية للمؤتمر، فليتفضل مشكورا.
Distinguished guests. In ESEM 18, the goal was to set new standards for emergency medicine education in the UAE by creating a rich environment that promotes and shares scientific research. Now, I invite Dr. Nadeem Qureshi, chair of the ESEM 18 Scientific Committee, to please deliver his speech.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. His Excellency, Humayd Al-Qattami, Director General of the Dubai Health Authority, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Good morning and welcome to ESEM 18. I have no words to express what we just saw. This is what makes emergency medicine a different specialty compared to any other specialty of medicine. The instant gratification. You can actually make a difference in somebody's life, not only at that moment, but for years to come. And this is why I think we are so passionate about our specialty. On behalf of the Scientific Committee, ESEM 18, I would like to welcome all local and international delegates who have come to attend this beautiful 5th Annual Emergency Medicine Conference organized by ESEM in the beautiful city of Dubai. Wow, it has been 5 years since we started this journey. It seems it was yesterday when we sat down and wrote the manuscript for this conference. Every year, I stand on this platform and I describe to you what to expect during the meeting. We strive hard and we try to deliver the best we can, always coming back the following year to improve it. Today, I will share some glimpses of this journey. It's a short period of time, but you would agree after hearing my thoughts that the milestones accomplished by this conference are way higher than what we had even imagined when we started this journey. Our stats indicate that our attendance has doubled since we started 5 years ago. This meeting has become a go-to, must-go-to meeting for the region, for the country. The scientific program continues to attract many global EM leaders. They come to share their thoughts, their ideas, their knowledge. They exchange a lot of views, a lot of networking, to the point that I and Saleh have been approached multiple times by different subspecialties to incorporate them into the scientific program. This year, again, is no different. The scientific program has some headline tracks from the past years, which has always been very, you know, sort of highlight, like the Fulcrum, the Picaclue. And we always try to add some new tracks. The ones this year we've added is on wellness, sports medicine, metabolic emergencies, and environmental emergencies. I expect nothing different this edition. We have some fabulous speakers who will deliver cutting-edge scientific knowledge, and you'll be able to appreciate a lot of new information. We just completed our pre-conference workshop yesterday, attended about like by 300 people, and I heard some raving reviews from each one of them who participated. This year, based on our assessment, we decided that we wanted the delegates to be a part of this process too. So I'm advocating two awards, which will be outlined, which will be given to two individuals for ESEM 18. One would be the person who conducts the best moderation, and two, the second person, the speaker who gives the outstanding talk for ESEM 18. The delegates, you are going to get a card from the quality team as we finish this plenary, this opening session ceremony. Please nominate whom you felt did an outstanding job of moderation during a track, and then the second one for a speaker. We will acknowledge both of them in our closing ceremony. The purpose of introducing these awards is clearly there. We want people to increase their, you know, potential. We know you have great potential, and hopefully this will fire you up. And moderation is something where I strongly feel that they can make a huge difference in making a track go right or left. I sincerely feel that the moderators do play a very important job, so I want the moderation to be at par. Development of research activity has been an important objective of ESEM and this conference in this country. And all of you know that we initiated the Resident Journal Club track for the same reason. The winner comes back each year, you know, the following year as a guest speaker. Let me share a few things about the Abstract Review Committee. The Abstract Review Committee has had a very interesting journey too. So when we started ESEM 5 years ago, we were receiving abstracts mentioning results will be announced later, 30% of them. Guess what? They all got turned down. The rejection rate was 45% in your first year. We had set a mandate that we will not compromise on sub-quality of abstract submissions. The word got around. In fact, some of the residents walked up to me in my second or third year and said, why did we not win this abstract competition? So me and abstract committee members sat down with a bunch of people and taught them how to write an abstract. The good thing was that the following year they came back well-prepared, taken the direction, and they actually won the competition. And it was extremely gratifying to see that we are making some headways in research activities in the region. The following years, we have seen a tremendous improvement in abstract submission, the quality. So the abstract committee chair has been, you know, asking me for the last 2 years to increase the number of abstract reviewers and the footprint in the program. So as of today, I'm happy to announce to you that following year, we'll have, instead of 8 oral presentations, 16 oral presentations. So plenty of opportunities for young investigators to present their research activities. This is what I say when I meant that we have accomplished some significant milestones, even though we are only in our 5th edition of this meeting. ESEM 18 app is available and allows everybody to give his feedback. So let me share another story of the feedback, you know, how significant was the feedback. So one of the feedback we were reviewing last year was the fact that the lecture given was of poor quality because it was copied from the textbook of emergency medicine. Obviously, it was very bothersome to me to hear that point, so I ended up reviewing the lecture and the chapter, and it turned out that the speaker was the author of that original chapter. So, we still love to hear your feedback. Be positive. That's how we improve ourselves. And in the last, I would like to say, with this extensive agenda and the meeting, I would like to thank every single one, all the meet committees, especially the speakers who have come from far and beyond from the time and the preparations they've put in to make this a great scientific meeting. Lastly, enjoy the city of Dubai, great weather, great food, and for some of us, we got a relief from the tremendous, miserable, you know, freezing temperatures back home. I look forward to hearing your thoughts and ideas for today and future. Thank you.
نشكر الدكتور نديم قرشي. ضيوفنا الكرام، إنه في نهاية حفلنا الكريم، نمد جميعنا شكرنا وامتناننا إلى سمو الشيخ حمدان بن راشد آل مكتوم لرعايته الكريمة لهذا المؤتمر، وإلى معالي حميد القطامي مدير عام هيئة الصحة بدبي على حرصه الدؤوب لإنجاح هذا المؤتمر، ونشكر الشركات الراعية والمؤسسات الإعلامية الداعمة للمؤتمر. وإننا ندعو ممثل راعي الحفل معالي حميد القطامي لافتتاح المعرض المصاحب للمؤتمر مع الدكتور صالح فارس.
As we approach the end of the ceremony, we would like to thank His Highness Sheikh Hamdan bin Rashid Al Maktoum for his continuous patronage of this prestigious conference. And we would also like to extend our gratitude to His Excellency Hamid Al Qatami for ensuring the success of this conference. In addition, we would like to extend our gratitude to the Emirates Medical Association board members, our distinguished delegates, and our generous sponsors.